Shame that causes depression. Hi, I'm Jim Richter. I'm the pastor of the Vine Church in Walker, Michigan, and we're doing a little video series on the different emotions that shame causes in our life. And today it's depression. And I think if you listen to the video on anxiety, it's similar. This is really clinical, needs to be addressed under the care of a physician. It's a real aspect of mental illness. And we need to minister to that. It also has the spiritual component to it, the emotional component that we can minister to with the love of Jesus. You know, when a person is depressed, sometimes we can't even put our finger on why. We're just down. We feel like we're in a pit and it's dark all around. And sometimes we read the Psalms and we see that David, who wrote over half the Psalms in the Bible, often felt that way. And God ultimately was his hope, his deliverer. You know, one of the great things about Jesus is he doesn't remove himself from depression or say that it doesn't exist. He crawls into that dark pit with us. Isn't that what Jesus' life and death on the cross was all about? He came to where sinners were. He came to where people were broken and hurting and sick and down. And he came to be with us right there. In the darkness of the cross, he was with us in the lowest point of our existence when we were just down in our sins. And he took them all. And he rose up in victory. And that's what he wants to do when someone's feeling depressed and down. He wants to say, hey, there's no shame. I love you. I've taken care of your sin problem. And I'm with you right now in these physical battles you have. And hey, I am lifting you up. I am victorious. I will never, ever die. You who believe in me will never, ever die. And someday I'm going to have you in a perfect place where there's no crying or tears or pain and you never go down in this dark pit again. I'm going to walk with you now and help you through and we'll get there together. That's our Jesus. He's risen and he's with you today.